Welcome to Pulse, your video news from the UNSW Business School. I'm Amy from the Real Estate Society, and today I've been given the opportunity to chat with Joseph Gyourko, Professor of Real Estate from Wharton Business School. Hi Joe, welcome to UNSW.
It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me.
Firstly, Joe, many students have developed this misconception that real estate studies are simply about selling houses. That's really not the case, is it?
No, it's not. Certainly when you look at the total real estate portfolio, housing's very important. It's a big part of any society, my country, your country. But most of the value and most of the jobs in the industry are in the commercial real estate sector, and that includes all income producing real estate. It's everything from hotels to malls to office buildings to industrial warehouse space to apartment buildings and the like. Both in value terms and job terms, commercial real estate's bigger.
Why should students study real estate?
Because it's so important in our lives. It's a big part of the asset base, so it's a big part of the financial markets and the broader economy. But it's also the decisions that happen in property markets decide where we live, how we live. They decide how we work, what the work environment's like, and the like. So I think the questions are really important economically and socially. And if those are things that attract you, I think real estate's a great subject to study.
In Australia at present, we have seen sharp rises in house prices, particularly in the Sydney market. Some say there's a bubble, others disagree. Does the recent experience in the US market have any lessons for Australians?
The lessons for the US, I think, are from the US are pretty clear, and that is prices go up and they go down. So if they've been going up a lot in Sydney, you should not be surprised if they go down. And if households and banks allow excessive leverage on peak prices, when prices fall, there's a threat to the financial system. That's what hit the U.S. and hurt the U.S. a lot. So were I a regulator in Australia, I would be worried about increasing leverage at a time of high and rising prices.
Based on your experience, what are your top three tips for students who wish to distinguish themselves in the commercial real estate industry?
I think first and foremost, be passionate about whatever sector you're going to be in, whether it's development, finance, just running buildings and portfolios, be passionate. Number two, I think, would be learn broad business skills. Don't just learn about real estate. They need people who can run businesses, who can read balance sheets, understand marketing, know how to lease, things like that. So be broad. And then number three is just be interested in a lot of things. The world changes, the real estate industry changes, you'll have to change with it. Be open to the change whenever it occurs in whatever sector you go into.
Thank you so much, Joe, and I hope you enjoy your stay in Australia.
Thank you very much.
Well, that's it for Pulse. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep up to date with all the latest news from the business school. Until next time, see ya!